Hari Om, dear students. Hope you have understood the previous part of the first lesson, that is the fun they had. And now here is the second part of the lesson, the fun they had. So let's get into the second part. Before getting into the second part, let's have a brief revision of the previous class. That is, in the story, this is a story totally about the future classrooms, isn't it? Yeah. So how the future education will be, all these things we have discussed. And in the story we have two characters by name Maggie and Tommy. Both of them are brother and sisters. Maggie is of only 11 years and Tommy is of 13 years. They have totally virtual classroom, where in the home itself they one of the rooms was designed as a classroom where computers and mechanical teacher are there. And they never go to school, and in fact they didn't even see a school. And once this Tommy had found a book in one of the old attics of his home, and that was really very new kind of an experience to both of them. And Maggie had written about the book in her diary. And both of them were very interested to see what is written. And unexpectedly, it was totally surprising to them that the content in the book was about a school. And moreover, these kind of books, they have never seen. Almost they are having e-books or digitalized documents which they see in the systems, and they do refer the books in the system itself. They have never seen a paper and a pen which we are using. So in the previous class we have even discussed about the ancient kind of a education, how gurukulas were there, and present education, and how future education will be. That means after 130 or 150 years, how the education will be. That is the main theme of our lesson. So in the last class we have ended with Maggie hating to do her homework, because she has to complete the homework in the form of a punch code which was made to learn when she was 6 years, isn't it? And she used to do the test papers or the worksheets or the homework, and she used to put in the slot in the system itself, and immediately the mechanical teacher used to correct it and give the feedback or the marks of the test what she is writing, isn't it? So in this way the things were going on, and once there was a problem with the geography subject and a county inspector. Here county inspector is nothing but the person who just looks after the faults of the system, like we can say hardware engineer, isn't it? So the person had come and he tried to mend the system, and somehow he got it ready, and then he said that everything is fine. But still Maggie was not so happy about that. She thought that somehow this geography sector will be removed or deleted, but somehow it was not done. And the most important thing is she didn't like to do such kind of a homeworks or test papers and put it in the slot. So with this we have stopped the previous session, isn't it? So now let's get into the part 2 and see how Maggie and as well as Tommy, they're going to do the things. Okay children, yeah, now let's get into the lesson. The inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Maggie's head. So here the inspector, in the sense the county inspector who had come to Maggie's house to mend the system, like there was some problem, technical problem with the system, where Maggie was always getting very less marks in geography session especially. So the county inspector had come to Maggie's house to rectify that problem, and somehow he had done it, and he just patted on Maggie's head. Patted is nothing but it's a kind of an action, just on your shoulder or on your head. A parent or the elders, just they pat it on it is an act of encouragement. So he patted on Maggie's head and he said to her mother. Her mother, in the sense here Maggie's mother, and Maggie's mother name is Mrs. Jones. So he said that it is not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was get a little quick. So here what this county inspector is saying that there is nothing fault on the part of a girl. Girl is very good and she is very good enough in her subject, but there was a problem with the geography sector. That means regarding a geography, there is some problem. The problem is it was geared little too quick. Here geared in the sense, here you can see the meaning, it is adjusted to a particular standard of a level. That means actually the girl is here 10 years and it is being adjusted a little quicker. That means the standard of the geography sector was nearly of a 12 or 13 years age student, and that's why this girl Maggie couldn't perform well in her test. So here the county inspector said that there is no problem with the girl and there is no fault of a girl also, and there is some technical problem with the geography sector where it was geared little too quick in the sense of a age, and those things happen sometimes. So very rarely such kind of a mistakes might be happening with the system. So now I have rectified, that means I have slowed it up. That means he had slowed it, the geography sector, to an average 10 year student level. It was nearly a 12 to 13 year student level. Now he had brought it back. That means he had slowed down the geography sector to a 10 year average student level, and hope now everything will be fine. The overall pattern of her, and he is also saying that the overall pattern of her progress is quite satisfactory. That means the girl is doing very well. So there is no need to put any force on her or trouble her just by thinking that she is getting a very low grades in her test. In fact, she is performing very well in this test, and the only problem with the system, somehow I have tried to rectify it, and now everything will be fine. He said, and he by saying that, he just again patted on Maggie's head. Okay, so this is the thing which had happened with the county inspector. He came, he had solved the problem, and he said that there is no fault on behalf of the girl, and also he said that there is a problem with the geography sector. Okay, and by listening all these things, though there is no problem with the Maggie's what do we call performance, still she was disappointed. Okay, here children, can you guess why was she disappointed though there was no fault on behalf of her? Can you guess? This happens sometimes. Actually, here see, she had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. See children, this happens with you when you don't like some subject or when you don't like something. What do you wish to happen? You wish to skip the thing or that subject, and you'd like to go to the one which you like most, isn't it? So here also the Maggie is thinking the same thing. See here, Maggie is thinking that somehow this county inspector may take away the teacher. That means the geography sector will be taken away permanently. That was the expectation of Maggie, but it didn't happen. See, here is the county inspector who is trying to rectify the problem, but somehow he had rectified it, and he even said that there is no problem with Maggie's performance still. But Maggie is disappointed because she is expecting something more. That is nothing but she had expected to remove the total geographic sector. Okay, the teacher will be taken away permanently, but it didn't happen. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month. So when his brother, like Tommy, he had a problem with Tommy's teacher of one of the subjects, nearly I think history sector. So when there was some problem with the history sector, the county inspector had come and he had taken away the teacher nearly for 1 month. So 1 month he didn't go through the history sector. So in the same way here, even Maggie was expecting the same thing. Oh God, let it happen that this county inspector may take away this geography sector. Even how it happened with Tommy, but it didn't happen with Maggie here. But he had just slowed down the geography sector to a 10-year level. Okay, and after that, for 1 month it was taken away with Tommy's history sector, and then totally they have blanked it. So that is very nice, no? That's what even you will be expecting with your tough subject or the subject which you don't like, isn't it? So in the same way here, even Maggie was thinking that, so at least it will be taken away, geography sector will be taken away for one month, or it may be blanked out completely how it had happened with Tommy's teacher. But poor thing is, it didn't happen with Maggie. So she said to Tommy, why would anyone write about school? So after all these things, again they have come back to the book which they had found, Tommy had found in his house in the attic. Okay, so here she says that, see, homework is very boring, schools are very, very uninteresting things. So why anyone in the world will write about school? Do people write about school? She is questioning Tommy, because here she doesn't like this kind of a school, especially here, virtual classroom where she sits and every slot is being arranged so systematically, homework is done, and even the test papers and the worksheets, she had to do it in a punch code which she had learned at the age of 6 years, and she should put it everything in a scheduled way. And even the mechanical teacher gives this result immediately, isn't it? So all these things, when they are happening, somehow there was some kind of a hesitation towards the school to Maggie, and then with that kind of a hesitation, she asked Tommy, why would anyone write about school? Will they write? It's so boring and uninteresting. That was the feeling of Maggie here. Yeah, when Maggie asked such a question, that why would anyone write about a book, Tommy looked at her with a very superior eyes. That means, Buddhu, what are you speaking in that way? Tommy just looked at her with a very different feeling, and he said that, because it is not our kind of a school, our kind of a school in the sense of virtual classroom or online classrooms, what we are facing just now after 100 years later, totally that kind of a classroom will be different, isn't it? So here he's saying that, hey, no, it is not our kind of a school where the schools will be in our homes itself. It's too pale. It is not our kind of school. Tommy is saying, and he's also saying that this is the old kind of school that they had hundreds of years ago. He added loftily, pronouncing the word carefully, centuries ago. So when Maggie asked her, when Maggie asked him such a question, like why would anyone write about a book, about a school in a book, he said that, hey, no, stupid, it is not a kind of a school, like a virtual classroom in the home itself, but it is totally different kind of a school. See, here you can see the picture of a classroom where the students are sitting in a real classroom, whereas in the this picture you can see the students in online class. And in future it will be totally different. Even it can be a virtual classroom where the systems and everything will be arranged in the home, in one of the rooms itself. Like, no, you can visualize it in our AV room class. In that way you can imagine it. So it is not our classrooms or our schools, but it is a old kind of a school. So here you can see old kind of a classroom here, and which was 100 years ago. Like centuries ago, he added loftily, in the sense very superiorly, like as though he know everything. Here Tommy is pretending that he knows everything, and he said that, hey, no, stupid, it is not our kind of school, it is totally different kind, and it is in fact centuries ago. Okay, and with these words Maggie was little hurt, and she said, well, I don't know what kind of a school they had all that time ago. She read the book over his shoulder for a while, then she said, anyway, they had a teacher. Okay, so here Maggie, she felt because of Tommy's words, and she said that, okay, let it be, but I don't know the kind of the schools what they had time ago, like long ago. What kind of schools were there? I don't know. I'm talking about our schools. Who the hell in the world will write about our schools? That was a feeling of Maggie here. And by saying that, she just peeped over Tommy's shoulder, and she started reading the book, and she said that, anyway, they had a teacher. That means they are having a teacher. But now is Maggie having a teacher? No, they are totally mechanical teacher. And see here, sure, they had a teacher, but it wasn't a regular teacher what we are having here. It was a man. So Tommy said that, yeah, they had a teacher, but it is not a regular teacher what we have, like, you know, the mechanical teacher in our virtual classroom. But today the teacher is human teacher. It was a man. That words were really surprising to Maggie. A man? How could a man be a teacher? So surprisingly here Maggie was asking, human being, a man, how could a man be a teacher? Because here she had never seen a human being as a teacher. So that was her own experience. Well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. So here Tommy is saying that, yeah, a man by name teacher, he just tells the boys and girls the things and explains. He just explains the lessons and do the things, and also he gives homework and asks questions. So in that way they were discussing about the human teachers centuries ago. Just you can imagine us, our own present situation where human teachers teach the classes, explain and conduct exams, everything, isn't it? We do give homework, we do ask questions, we do conduct examinations, isn't it? So here Tommy was explaining that, oh no, it is not our kind of a teacher, it's a human teacher, where humans explain the things and even they give homework and as well as they ask questions. In this way Tommy tried to explain Maggie how the classrooms or the schools was in fact in long ago, centuries ago, you can say. A man isn't smart enough. So by saying that, how can a human being be so smart to teach? That was so questioning and a huge doubt to Maggie. And here you can see a human being as a teacher, and he's teaching to two kids here. So sure, he is. My father knows as much as my teacher. He knows almost as I much, I betcha. So here both of them are talking to each other, and here he's saying that, yes, why can't a human being be very smart? Because my father, he knows as much as my teacher. Here my teacher, in the sense, you should clearly understand children. My teacher, in a sense, mechanical teacher. So Tommy is saying that why can't a human being be so smart enough? Because my father, he himself is very good enough that he knows everything what my teacher explains. So in that way, Tommy tried to clarify Maggie. So he almost knows everything. I betcha. So here, I betcha is nothing but I bet you. See here, I have even given the meaning. I bet you. So I'll just bet you, like no, kind of a what will promise? Yes, definitely. My father knows this. You have a betting with your friends or your parents. Yes, definitely. I bet that I will do it. Or it will happen. It will definitely rain today. I will bet you. In this way, you just put up, keep on betting with others, isn't it? So in that way, here Tommy, he was betting with Maggie. Yeah, my father knows as much as how our mechanical teacher knows. So in that way, they were talking, and Maggie wasn't prepared to dispute that. She said, "I wouldn't want a strange man in my house to teach me." So somehow, okay, you are saying that your father is very good enough and he is very good as even teacher, but somehow I am not to have a dispute with you. That means I don't want to argue with you, but it may be possible, like human teachers might be there and they used to come to schools and teach students and everything might be happening, but I definitely don't want a stranger. Like no, here how a person is explaining students, how he is teaching, in that way I don't want a strange man in my house to teach me. Definitely I don't like someone coming to my house and teaching every day. For God's sake, I don't want human teacher. In that way, here Maggie was answering Tommy, and Tommy screamed with laughter. That means he laughed very loudly. And he said that you don't know much, Maggie. So you don't know anything here. The teacher didn't live in the house. The teacher didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. And all the kids learned the same thing. Sure, if they were the same age. So in that way, when Maggie said that I don't want to have a strange man to be in my home to teach, Tommy, he laughed very loudly and he said that, hey, no, you don't know anything about schools, Maggie. See here, teachers, they doesn't live in your home. That means they didn't live in your home. They will not come to your home to teach. They will have a special building here. So what is a special building here, children? Can you imagine? It is nothing but school. Special building is called as here school, where we go very regularly, isn't it? So all the teachers and students, they assemble there, and all the, even, you know, one more surprising thing is all the kids, they learn the same thing. Common topic is being explained to all the students. It is not like our own classroom where each and every student will have a different topics or a different slots where the mechanical teacher explains. No, it is not in that way. Here, all the students of the same age probably, they go to school and they sit together, and a common topic is explained to the group of the student by the human teacher. So it is in that way a human teacher teaches in the schools. It is not like our own kind of a mechanical teacher who teaches us in our own houses. Hope you have understood, Maggie. Tommy was asking Maggie. But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently. So when in this Maggie, when she heard Tommy's words, she had a doubt, and she said that my mother, she always says that teacher was something that should be adjusted to the mindset of each and every boy or a girl, whomever they are dealing with. like no, even in the classrooms we do have the same thing, but here this boy, when he said all these things, Maggie was unable to accept it, and she said that my mother says that a teacher should be in such a way that the teacher should be analyzing the boy or the girl, and the mechanical teacher should be teaching each and every kid in a very different way. It is not that a group of students sitting together in the school and they're teaching. No, it is not like that. The teacher should be adjusted to the capabilities of the student, and they should teach very differently and individually. That was the feeling of Maggie here. Just the same, they didn't do it that way then. If they don't like it, you don't have to read book. So see, so here Tommy, he was little annoyed. He got little annoyed, and he said that okay, just the same they didn't do it then the way then. If you don't like it, so if you don't like it, the previous schools and the previous classes, it's so simple. You don't read this book. That's it. The problem solved in this way. Tommy tried to put a word to Maggie that not enough for reading the books or about the school. And then she said that I didn't like it. Maggie said quickly she wanted to read about those funny schools. So here Maggie said that, so I'm not saying that I'm totally against to those kind of schools or I didn't like it. In fact, I wanted to read about those funny schools. Like now see here, you can see the school building where all the students assemble there and teachers in the classroom. Okay. They weren't even half finished when Maggie's mother called Maggie's school. So when all this conversation was going on between Maggie and Tommy, they haven't even finished reading the book half. That means half of the book was also not finished. And meanwhile, Maggie's mother called Maggie's school. That means school time has started, and Maggie looked at. Not at mama. That means the time has not yet started. That means it's not time for the school. Still a little time is there. And then, now, said Mrs. Jones, and it's probably time for Tommy too. So even Tommy's mother, she said that now, yes, Tommy, even it is your time. And when both the mothers, like Tommy's mother and Maggie's mother, called that it was time for a school, both Maggie said to Tommy, can I read the book some more with you after the school? So they have planned to read the book after the school, and they have gone back to their virtual classroom where they have to get with on their studies. Maybe, he said nonchalantly in the sense here, not showing much interest. Okay, after the school we may read. So very uninterestingly and unenthusiastically he said, okay, we'll continue. And then he walked away whistling, like no, he just went away to his classroom. The dusty old book tucked beneath his arm, he just put the book under his arm and he went away to his classroom to attend his classes, tucked beneath under his arm, in the sense just kept the book under his arm and he went away. So here you can see here a virtual classroom where the students sit in their home and they do it. So Maggie went into school room. So here you can imagine that it is a kind of a school room. It was right next to her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was on and waiting for her. It was always on at the same time every day except Saturday and Sunday, because her mother said little girls learn better if they learned at regular hours. So every Saturday and Sunday, every day they have a regular classes in the school room. The school room, where was the school room? It was just beside her a bedroom. It was not like our own school where we have a building and all the students assemble. No, it is not like that. Her virtual classroom is just placed beside her bedroom, and the mechanical teacher was waiting for the student. They hear Maggie here, and it is always, it is the same time, and every day except Saturday and Sunday they have the classes, because Saturday and Sunday was a off to their like a holiday for them. And here the mother of her mother, in the sense of Maggie's mother, she feels that little children are especially, they can learn more at regular hours, like no continuous learning will help them, systematic learning will help the children a lot. And somehow the school started in the virtual classroom. The screen was lit up and it said, today's arithmetic session lesson is on addition of a proper fraction. Please insert yesterday's homework in the proper slot. So the class has started and it is about the arithmetic lesson. Arithmetic lesson in on addition of a proper fraction. See here, you can see number of just I have given a number of symbols and as well as numbers, like addition and subtraction or multiplying, all these things comes under arithmetic lesson. So it was probably a math class, and even the mechanical teacher had asked to insert the yesterday's homework in the proper slot, which was done by Maggie by punch code. We have already discussed about this. So homeworks and even test papers, all these things were done by punch code. So the mechanical teacher had asked to insert it, and she even did it. When mechanical teacher asked her to submit the homework, she had done it with a sigh, and she was thinking about the old schools, like even still the old schools, and the book was in her mind, and she was thinking about the old school. And when her grandfather's grandfather was a little boy, like now see here is the picture of a old school, like our own kind of a school where children come out, they enjoy, isn't it? So all kids from the whole neighborhood came laughing and shouting in the schoolyard, sitting together in the class school room, going home together at the end of the day. They learned the same thing, so they could help one another with the homework and talk about it. And the teachers were people. The mechanical teacher was flashing on the screen when we add fractions 1 by 2 and 1 by 4. Maggie was thinking about how the kids must have loved it in the olden days. She was thinking about the fun they had. So here, when this Maggie was just, she submitted the homework and she said that she was thinking how these old schools will be, where all the kids, they go to school from all the neighborhood, they enjoy together by laughing, shouting, and they play in the schoolyard, they sit together in the school room, or you can say classroom, and they go home all together. So that is how we do at present, isn't it? We come to school together, we go to home together along with all the friends, either at the beginning of the day or end of the day we do spend time with our friends or neighbors, isn't it? And also they learn the same thing, like same topics are being explained to a group of children. It is nothing but each, like first class, second class, we do divide the students and we teach them, no? So all these things seemed very interesting to Maggie. So they learned same thing, and they could even help one another in doing homework. That is how we do homework, isn't it, at present? So in this way, Maggie was thinking about all those things, how beautifully those classrooms might be, how beautifully playground. So here you can see the picture of a school, playground and everything. And even she was more interested to know about the teachers, because the teachers were people but not a mechanical teachers. And when she was thinking all these things, immediately on the screen, on the computer screen, just there was a flash that we add 1 by 2 and 1 by 4, in the sense that means the math class has started, and she was into the virtual classroom to attend the class. And still she was thinking about how kids in those days have loved the schools in the olden days, and they might have had a lot of funniness. They might have enjoyed it, they might have loved it, and they might have lot of fun. In that way, Maggie was very happy about those kind of schools. Those kind, in the sense, the schools which we are having at present, children, try to understand. So now the Maggie is after 150 years in the virtual room, and she was thinking that, oh, in those kind of those days, that kind of schools might be very interesting. Like now how we discuss about Gurukulas, in the same way here Maggie is thinking about our own schools, that those schools are very, they might be very interesting, and the students might have enjoyed a lot, common learning and human teachers and good playgrounds, and the students come together and go home together, and they discuss the things. So all these things seemed very interesting to Maggie. So hope you have understood this prose part, children. So now let us discuss this question and answers of this lesson. Yes, children, let us discuss the question and answers of this prose part. So coming to the first question, how old are Maggie and Tommy? So here Maggie is of 11 years and Tommy is of 13 years, isn't it? If you listen carefully and read the textbook before the listening to this explanation, you can easily answer these questions, children. So now let us move to the second question. What did Maggie write in her diary? What did she write? She had written about the book which Tommy had found, isn't it? Yeah, that is what she has written. She wrote so and so date, Tommy had found a real book. And moving to the next question, had Maggie ever seen a book before? No, she had never seen a book. What things about the book did she find strange? The book was very strange to Maggie because the letters were printed on the book and they were not even moving. Actually, on the computer screen, the letters move and they have to read the scrolling letters. Whereas in the book, the letters were printed and they were not at all moving. And moreover, when they turn back the previous pages, the text is there on the page itself. It didn't disappear. So these things seemed very strange to Maggie. Moving to the next question, what do you think a telebook is? Telebook is nothing but you can see just e-books or some kind of a PDF copies which we are having it. So you do refer many sources and write answer to this. Moving to the next question, where was Maggie's school? Did she have any classmates? So Maggie's school was in her own house beside her bedroom, and it was a virtual classroom, and definitely she doesn't have any classmates. And moving to the last question, what subject did Maggie and Tommy learn? So here in this lesson, they have discussed about history and geography and as well as maths, isn't it? So these were the few subjects which they were learning. Okay. Yes, children, after listening this video, do understand, and if you have any doubts, try to contact us, okay? And you should write the classwork of this lesson on your own. Yes, children, hope you have enjoyed this session and the first lesson of our 9th class, that is the fun they had. And do write your classwork, and if you have any doubts, please contact us. Hari Om. Thank you.